Now, students, in this lecture, we are going to discuss tetracyclines. Tetracyclines themselves consist of the different drugs, and tetracycline is one among them. So, tetracyclines, why they are called tetracyclines? Tetra means four. This is because of the presence of the four rings in these drugs, and these are actually the fused rings which are connected to one another, and with the presence of the conjugated, that are the alternate double bonds. As shown in this figure, we have A, B, C, D. We have basically the four fused rings with conjugated double bonds. Now, coming towards the mode of action of the drug. The drug's mode of action is that this is a drug that inhibits the protein synthesis within the bacteria. The tetracyclines will enter into the bacteria with two different mechanisms. In two different ways. That is, in two different steps. Firstly, it will get entered into the bacteria by passive diffusion. Then it will utilize the energy, that is an energy dependent transport protein mechanism will be utilized by the drug to combat the bacteria. So I will discuss these two different steps after discussing its accumulation within the a microorganism or within the bacteria. First, we will see that, okay, after entering into the bacteria, they will get accumulated within the bacteria. After get accumulated within the bacteria, they will get access to the 30S ribosomal unit. And to this 30S ribosomal unit, your drug will bind reversibly. So after binding to this ribosomal unit, what this drug will do, this will prevent the access of this transfer RNA to a complex. And this complex is the complex of the messenger RNA with the ribosome, thus inhibiting the protein synthesis of the bacteria. This is the diagram which is representing that we have this 30S ribosomal unit and this messenger RNA. So we have this complex. And now what tetracycline is doing here, this is preventing the access of this transfer RNA towards this complex. Here it is written that tetracycline will target this 30S unit and will prevent the transfer or the binding of this transfer RNA to this messenger RNA. And this messenger RNA is actually complexed with the 30S unit. Now, again, coming towards the entrance of the tetracycline within the bacteria, how it will get itself entered into the bacteria. So, students, what this drug will do, it will enter into the bacteria with the help of the porins. Here I'm giving you the example of the gram-negative bacteria. The drug will enter with the help of the porins into the and will get accessed or will get accumulated within the periplasmic space without utilization of the energy. Now, your drug is in the periplasmic space, and for the further movement of the drug, what you need the energy. Now, to move across the cytoplasmic membrane, your drug will now require the energy. So, you can say that tetracyclines are initially not utilizing the energy, but after accumulating in the periplasmic space, they will need energy to move across the cytoplasmic membrane. Now, coming towards the antibacterial spectrum of the drug, that is against which bacteria your tetracyclines are active. These are basically the bacteriostatic drugs. These are the drugs which will just arrest the growth of the bacteria. And these are the drugs which are active against both gram-positive and gram-negative organisms. Or the bacteria, they are active against protozoa, spirochetes, mycobacteria, and atypical species. These drugs are specially used against or for the treatment of acne and chlamydia infection, especially the doxycycline. Now, coming towards the drug resistance. Now, there are different modes of resistance against the drug by the bacteria. The first one is the presence of the efflux pump. If the bacteria has the efflux pump in it, it will definitely expel or remove the drug out of the cell. From itself, the drug will be removed from the bacteria. There will be no accumulation of the drug within the bacteria. Your drug will now not bind to the 30S unit. And definitely, if it's not binding to 30S unit, there will be no protein synthesis inhibition. The second mode of resistance is the enzymatic inactivation of the drug by the bacterias. Now the third is production of the special bacterial proteins that will prevent the access of these tetracyclines, that will prevent the access of these drugs towards the ribosome, towards the 30S unit. And these are all the mechanisms that are basically the reason behind the resistance of the bacterias against the tetracyclines. One thing that you must remember is that if any bacteria is resistant against one tetracycline, it doesn't mean that it is resistant to all other drugs of the same class. So students, this was all about the mode of action, antibacterial spectrum, and the resistance of the tetracyclines.